who these people are.
Planet Dolan.
From a singer murdered by the president of her own fan club to a woman who killed her dog to get One Direction's attention, we count seven fans who turn into psychotic murderers. Hey everyone, my name is Melissa. I'm here to caress your brain cells with weird facts from all over the world.
Number seven.
There's usually no purer love than fan love, but this batshit crazy One Direction fan proved you can definitely love something too much.
One Direction fans.
This young woman was so desperate for her favorite boy band to follow her on Twitter that she threatened to murder her own dog. She sent pictures of herself pinning her pet chihuahua down by the throat and said she would break its neck if the band didn't comply and follow her. One Direction probably gets 50,000 Twitter messages on a slow day. 40,000 of them are marriage proposals. So it's unlikely that anyone in the 1D camp saw the deranged demand, much less responded to it. Of course, Crazy Fan took this as a rejection. She told Liam she loved him via tweet and enclosed a picture of herself crying and cradling her dead dog. It's possible this was a sick hoax, but regardless, she's definitely one disturbed individual. And that's not even getting into her questionable taste in music. Fellow One Direction fans labeled her as a psycho and told her to burn in hell. They've officially kicked her out of the 1D fan club, which for her would be a fate worse than death.
Number six.
Walking Dead fans are a lot like zombies. They operate as a hive mind. Some are a little slow, and they chomp at the bit for updates about their favorite show.
Are these, like, zombies?
It turns out some even have trouble distinguishing fiction from reality.
I'm a Walking Dead fan. Y'all
like
know
this
that.
23-year-old Mexican man who murdered his own friend because he thought he was a walker. Damon Perry had been drinking heavily and binge-watching The Walking Dead with his buddy, Christopher Paquin, when he suffered the murderous delusion. According to Damon, Chris all of a sudden changed into a zombie and tried to bite him. Using strategies from his favorite TV show, Damon fought back using his fists and the tools he had on hand. A
bathroom was a zombie.
Microwave.
I would be like,
and an electric guitar. Damon was charged with murder and aggravated assault.
That's a true Walking Dead fan.
The dictatorship was always going to be a bad influence.
Rick is right.
Number five.
American sitcom My Sister Sam struggled to get ratings during its two-season run. But one person never missed an episode. Psychotic fan Robert John Bardo, who was obsessed with the show star, Rebecca Schaefer. Robert was such a creeper that he hired a personal investigator to find Rebecca's home address, then turned up at her apartment. Rebecca graciously signed an autograph for him, but asked him to leave when he kept coming back. Robert took this as a rejection and snapped. He pulled a gun on Rebecca and shot her in the chest. He was arrested soon after, but Rebecca unfortunately didn't make it. She now stars in the great sitcom In the Sky.
Jesus.
Number four. Justin Bieber is a polarizing pop star.
Photo shoot.
I would do the same thing. Him. And plenty would probably like to cut off his balls. Jokingly, that is.
Turned?
Well, convict Dana Martin would like to do it for real. And he's a fan of the Biebs' music. Dana Martin is serving a life sentence for the rape and murder of a 15-year-old. But that didn't stop him from formulating a plan to castrate Canada's most famous pop star. Dana called Justin a good-looking kid and admitted he wanted to go to bed with him. He ordered his two associates to castrate Bieber with garden shears so that Dana could keep his favorite parts as a souvenir. Fortunately, Dana's hitmen were arrested before they pulled off their scheme. Not that they had a real shot anyway, given Justin's permanently surrounded by about 60 security guards.
Number three.
It turns out you can't trust anyone,
Selena Gomez,
not even the president
right?
of your own fan club.
Selena.
That's what the tragic death of Mexican-American singer Selena Quintanilla Perez teaches us. Selena was murdered by Yolanda Saldivar, the woman who ran both her fan club and clothing boutique. Yolanda was secretly
like
obsessed
like
with Selena and had a creepy shrine of her with posters, candles, and videos. She would have continued silently loving Selena from afar if she wasn't caught embezzling money from the fan club. After that, Selena cut ties with her, and Yolanda shot her during a final meeting to exchange tax documents. Yolanda was found guilty of murder and sentenced to life in prison.
Family friendly, so
number two.
What do you get when you mix the Beatles, Catcher in the Rye, and a mental instability? One of history's most devastating murders of a public figure. Mark David Chapman was a former armed guard who completely idolized John Lennon. He'd been briefly committed for hearing voices and attempting suicide, and always carried the angsty teenager's handbook, The Catcher in the Rye, with him wherever he went. In December 1980, Mark left Hawaii, one of the happiest places on earth, to murder John Lennon. He waited all day outside Lennon's New York apartment, clutching a loaded gun and his copy of Catcher. When Lennon returned with Yoko Ono from a recording session, Mark casually approached them and fired 5 shots. 4 of them hit Lennon, killing him instantly. Rather than showing signs of remorse, Mark stood around reading his book until police arrested him.
Number 1.
Don't you hate it when your favorite band splits up or changes styles? It's horrible, right? But at least you know it isn't justification to commit murder. Apparently, 24-year-old Nathan Gale didn't get the memo. The deranged fan broke into a club and shot Dimebag Darrell, the former guitarist of metal band Pantera, because he didn't like his new band. Pantera was a huge deal in the 90s, but split at the height of their popularity because of drug problems. Dimebag and his drummer Vinnie Paul formed new band Damage Plan, but Nathan couldn't accept this. He was stuck in the past. During Damage Plan's performance, Nathan, who was outside, jumped a 6-foot fence, rushed through the side door, and shot Dimebag in the head. The audience thought it was part of the show. Furious over the injustice of losing his favorite band, Nathan continued shooting into the crowd, killing several innocent people. He shot a roadie and took a hostage before the officer finally took him down from backstage. What a piece of shit. What the hell is wrong with humanity? Come on, people. Anyway, guys, live and learn what not to do from these douchebags.
Look at the kids. See you next time. Garlic knots for dinner. Peace.